guys, Jan here in the North View Model Shop, and I want to do a video I've been thinking about doing now for a very long time. We're talking 2 years, 3 years now, and this video is called Humble Beginnings. And guys, I want to take a trip down memory lane back to when we first started. Before, we had four different paint systems here. We're talking, you know, $1,000 worth of paints and specialty tools out the wazoo, a whole shelf full of glues and deckle sets and tapes and masking tapes and magnets and pin vices and three or four different containers of special sanding sticks and a whole closet full of model kits. We started literally in a closet, a room no bigger than a closet, with one 100 watt light bulb, an old makeup container. It's just a star oil container. The wife had makeup and shit in that she let us use, borrow temporarily, and one model kit. Some basic stuff. So guys, bear with us. We're gonna go through just humble beginnings, just back to where we started. So we go to our local hobby shop, rainy day. We want to say, let's get into building some models. So, and I always loved the Corsair, and I always thought, probably a great kit to start with. So we'd show up, and this is what I was eyeing. Mainly, it's Revell. It's what I call the thin box airplanes. $12, brand new, full price, full markup. Get it cheaper elsewhere, but had the kit, bought the kit. And I said to the guy there, so what am I going to need? I have nothing. So the guy hooked me up, and I don't have the exact paints anymore, but essentially we came home with four model master paints. And guys, great. Fit right there. It was wicked, right? So I was excited. So we got some basic tools. These are literally the ones I started with back in 2010, 2009. Where are those? The best glue money can buy. That's what we thought anyway at the time. Some testers. We had the red stuff, but this stuff here is the chemical-free or scent-free, non-toxic. Smells wicked awful. One hobby knife with one number 11 blade into it. How many number 11 blades do you need? Geez, you're only cutting plastic. About one, that's all we needed. One pair of tweezers. Now, I don't have the original ones I had. I just had the makeup tweezers, the personal care tweezers. These are quite big, but these freaking deckles, right? Some toothpicks, some Q-tips. I don't have the right one anymore, but essentially just the tester's paintbrush. This is just a water brush, but same friggin' thing at the time, right? One of those. A pencil, a pen. We went splurged, we got ourselves a Sharpie. And guys, this is probably the weirdest tool I had, was an old dart. And what we found was you just took your glue, put a little dab on a piece of cardboard, kind of scooped it up, put it on. Oh, and up here was our parts tree, our spare parts or half painted assemblies at the time. You put the old jelly glue right there. Woo! Great. There was our tools we had. And we had a drawer that was full of the most advanced clamps system known to man. Clothespins. We had a ton. We thought, man, we're never gonna use this many. And we've got thousands of these. Here's the drawer. Was the drawer. This had the most valuable things we had. Some of the other kits. Now, mind you, when we first started, we didn't have this drawer with that in it, but as we moved on to a few more kits, we had spare deckles. Our deckle container. And guys, that was pre-Northview Model Shop. That was the extent of our tools. And guys, you step back and you think about it. God, the times were simpler back then. It was just like being a kid then, right? You know, you look at being an adult now, it's like, God, I wish I was a kid again. Back then, sometimes I sit back and wish, man, I wish I was back to the days when we lived up on the North Mountain. The hobby room was 10 square feet. Nothing there, it was quiet. There was a computer, I had a desk that had this much working space onto it. It's beautiful, guys. Even when we moved down here to Northview Drive, and we were the North, this is still kind of pre-Northview Model Shop. That's all we had. When we were done, this all went up in the closet, so the little toddler, Andrew, was two, now eight, almost nine. Couldn't get into it, right? I went to a buddy's house like this one day with all everything I owned, like this, right? It was crazy. Now you look at all you guys are up there, right? You've all got huge paint racks, ungodly amount of supplies, a whole basement for your studios, right? Stashes, this 700-800 kits deep, right? It's great, great, great. But it's just amazing how fast you can go up, progress forward, buying tools, getting more stuff, getting more and more and more, and how much more difficult and complicated you make things for yourself. And sometimes you just want to step back and say, remember the humble beginnings. All right, guys, thanks for this tour. There's a reason why we did this video. It'll come more apparent later on in the couple weeks to come, but humble beginnings, guys. Just take a minute, think back what things are worth. Guys, if you're excited, do a video just the same. Kind of show us what you started with and where you've ended up today. Anyway, guys, thanks for tuning in.